makeup. I always moisturize my face and also apply some few drops of squalane oil. Right now my face is really glowy and that's because I have prepped my skin using the CeraVe moisturizing cream. I've got the big size because I go through moisturizer like water. I moisturize my skin every single day, 7 to 8 times a day if that's possible. The moisturizing cream is a bit thick, so I do go in with squalane pure oil. Few drops of this and this combined, oh my god, it's like amazing. And this is the CeraVe sunscreen that I use. This is the CeraVe AM facial moisturizing lotion. I do prep my skin every single day, even though if I'm not wearing makeup, if I'm not going out, if I'm just sitting home. The first product that I use is the Kat Von D concealer, and this is in the shade D31 Warm. I'm in love with this concealer. So I take this and I apply it all over like my blemishes and scars that I have. There was a time when I first tried this concealer. I really liked it. I finished the whole tube up. Then for Secret Santa, I had asked like my best friend to get me this concealer. And I know it's pretty expensive, and in my head, I'm like, okay, I don't think she's gonna buy it because it's pretty expensive with the taxes and everything. It's like 160 bucks in Dubai. 160 is what? $40, $30. But she got me this, and then she told me there was like a huge sale going on, and I'm like, what sale? When does Kat Von D have sale on Sephora? I don't know why she had one, but she had one going on. So she told me it was very cheap. It was just 40 dirhams. That's $10. I was speechless. I drove home ASAP and I sat in and I ordered 3 of these concealers. One is in my car and here I have 2 of them, like still in its original packaging. Love, love, love this concealer. I'm also applying it all over my eyelids. Once I'm done with that, I'm going in with my MAC Studio Fix powder. This is in the shade NC45. No, it's NC43, sorry. And I just pack it all over my face. I also apply powder over my eyebrows because my eyebrows do get shiny towards the end of the day. And also my eyelids. Moving on to my third product, I'm going to be using the Lilly Lashes Glam 3D Mink Lashes, and this is in the style Miami. Everyone and their pets and their exes wear these lashes. Like, it's everyone I know. Small channels to the big channels, everyone, like literally everyone wears these Miami 3D Mink Lashes. So that's the reason I picked this up. Applying these 3D lashes using my dual lash glue and my tweezer. Once I'm done with my lashes, I jump on to my lips. I genuinely don't have lashes, like I really don't have lashes. So I don't really like to put mascara to blend them in because I genuinely don't have lashes. I completely skip the whole mascara step. But of course, if you wanna go ahead with it, you can. This is my first time trying Miami lashes and I really like them. They're really wispy and the band is a bit thick, but yeah, I really like it. So now I'm gonna be pretty much jumping to the lips. You guys know it's my favorite part of my makeup. This is my favorite MAC Cosmetics Cork lip liner. I do have the big size, but I kind of lost it. I just bought it recently. I don't know where it went. So I'm just gonna go in with a smaller piece. Once I'm done lining my lips, I do go in with these two liquid lipsticks. The first one I go in with is Commando from Kylie Cosmetics. Then I go in with a birthday suit from Kylie Cosmetics as well. It's just the mini size liquid lipstick from her birthday collection. And I just dot in the center. Take my ring finger and I tap it in. My final step is just going in with some contour powder. The one that I've been using so much as of like last year is the Sleek Makeup Dark Contour Kit. And this brush that I got from Morphe, this is the Morphe M557. This is, in my opinion, the perfect contouring brush. It's really skinny, really tiny. You could see this goes in right here, so it's not too big, because I used to use something like this, it would look like someone punched me in the face. Also, like, we really don't blend the contour on this channel, so you know, I really like unblended contour. I like my contour to be harsh and very sharp, so I like a very tight fluffy brush, like, if that makes sense. It's really tiny but also very fluffy, so you do get a harsh contour with this. At the same time, it's kind of diffused, so yeah. I like to first contour my jaw, make it really sharp. And once I'm done with my jaw contouring, I go on to my cheeks now. And then my cheeks, I honestly push back like my hair, and then I push it into my like my side buns. And then like I like to pounce it as well. I also like to contour my forehead, temples. So this is the finished makeup look. Favorite product that I can't live without is the Kat Von D concealer in D 31 warm. It's my favorite concealer. And this is the kind of makeup look that I've been wearing as of lately. I feel like everyone, when they do their makeup, their main focus is their eyeshadow or your lashes or your lips or your nose contour. For me, it has to be lashes and lips. So yes, the main focus is the lashes and it's also the lips. Anncy's makeup look is quite incomplete without her unblended contour. So I love unblended contour as well. So these are the kind of items that I genuinely cannot live without. Number one, concealer, MAC Studio Fix Powder, contour, lipstick, and lashes. So I think it's 5. Also, I realized I did my eyebrows off camera, so it's kind of 6. Whoopsie! Also, moisturizer and sunscreen, so 7, 8. Squalane oil, that's 9. Yeah, I just realized I fucked up, but like, whatever, it's still 5 in my eyeballs. Don't get me wrong, there are some days I don't like to look anything, not even remotely close like my passport picture. I love to transform myself with makeup, I love that, but this is kind of like my winter makeup look. So yeah, hopefully you really like how this tutorial came out. If you don't, it's fine, just dislike. I'm kidding. Hopefully, if you're like a newcomer, new first-time watcher, please go watch something else. This is like one of the most boring looks I've ever filmed. Thank you so much for watching, subscribe, like, and I'll see you guys in my next video.